Love Sarah here, and today I'm going to show you two different ways to turn a photo or artwork to black and white in Clip Studio Paint. Please feel free to stick around to the end to see a cool trick you can do with this tutorial. The two ways I'm going to show you how to turn a photo black and white will allow you to still have the ability to use color on different layers in your file. So if you go over here and say grab an orange and then create a new layer, the whole file's not in black and white color. Still add color to it. It's just the image we're making black and white. Don't panic if your Clip Studio's layout is different to mine. Yours will most likely be the default layout. I have rearranged mine to how I like it. All the tools you'll need will still be the same. Method 1. Lower the saturation. Step 1. Open Clip Studio Paint. Drag and drop the file from wherever your image is in your documents into the program. Alternatively, go File, Open, and then go to wherever your image is and then click the little Open button. Step 3. Go up to the top bar, select Layer, select New Correction Layer, Hue, Saturation, and Lumosity, and a little pop-up window will appear. In the little pop-up box, grab the arrow and drag all the way to the left to a minus 100, press OK, and voila, a black and white image. If you don't want to make any more changes to the image, you can now save it, go File, Save as Duplicate, and choose either JPEG or PNG, depending on whatever you're using the image for. You can also choose any of the other ones, like I said, it depends what you're using it for. Just note that PNG will be a larger file size, but it has no compression, therefore it's more crisp and clear. Also, if you want to keep the Clip Studio Paint file, keeping all the layers for editing at a further date, go File, Save As, name the file, and save as Clip Studio format, which is the Clip Studio format here. Just go black and white tiger. And boom, you're done. And then you're done with method 1. Method 2, changing the layer blend mode. I'm going to show you how to create black and white, but you can use this method the same way to get that old timey sepia brown look. Instead of choosing black, choose a brown color. So instead of choosing black, choose a brown color. Now, I have never used the sepia before, so you might need to play around to get the correct brown sepia shade you want, or Google the sepia hex color code. Please note you can use any color you want with this. It's not just black or sepia. Feel free to play around and experiment and have fun. So same as before, open Clip Studio Paint and then import your image. With this method, go over to your layers, which is over here. Click on this one, which is the new raster layer, to create a layer above the image that you're using. Next, go over to the toolbar or to wherever you use it and select the fill or paint bucket tool. Make sure you have refer to editing layer only selected. Then go over to your color wheel or color chart, whatever one you're using. Select black. Making sure you're on the new layer that you created, go over to your artwork, left click to use the paint bucket tool. Oh look, the screen's gone all black, but don't panic. Go back over to the layers and make sure you have the black fill layer selected. Then go up here to your layer blending mode and then go down to color, and there you are, a black and white image created a different way. And just as before in the previous method, save however you wanted it saved, either as JPEG, PNG, or Clip Studio Paint. There you go, another black and white image using a different method. Depending on the project you're using, it doesn't really matter what method you use. It all comes down to what you find easiest. And that is the end of the two easiest methods to create a black and white photo or image in Clip Studio Paint. And now I'll show you the cool little bonus other trick I promised at the start. I'm just going to be using the file that I just used in the second method, but you can use either method. On your black layer, create a layer mask, hit it, and then making sure you can switch between the black and the white, making sure you're on white, which is the layer mask. In Clip Studio Paint, you need to use the eraser tool. In Photoshop, you use paint, either black or white, but in Clip Studio, you use the eraser tool. So you either use the eraser tool and then it hides that layer, which in our case is the black layer. But I personally prefer to use the brush tools because you can have a bigger range of textures to use rather than just the eraser's small selection, but to use the brushes, you have to go down to here, see where you have your two color options, click the checkered box, which is your transparency. It's making the brush transparent, aka an eraser. So, choosing your favorite brush or pen from the tools list, I have, these are custom made ones. You will most likely want the G pen or the real G pen or the paint side tool pen or whatever your favorite brush is, but I would recommend the G pen. And making sure that you have this transparency selected, making sure you're on the white box of the clip mask, zoom in on areas you want to erase the clip mask, such I'm doing the eyes. Now I'm gonna rush it, but when you're doing yours, you can do it more carefully. And voila, you have a cool black and white photo with a little bit of color showing through. Obviously, if you want, you can always add more color in different areas. It's up to you where you want the color and where you want the black and white. This is just a cool little effect that I love doing to photos or even artworks. The brilliant thing about using a layer mask is that anything you do is not permanently deleted. You can always fix it. Like, say if you want this to go back to black and white, turn off the transparency and then just paint back in that area. You must make sure that you stay on the white layer mask that you've added though. You will notice that when you add things or erase things, it will change. So white means visible, black means invisible. So see where the eyes are? See how the eyes are showing through, but it's black on there? Black means that it's invisible. Just remember, if you're coming to Clip Studio Paint from Photoshop, the masks are different. You have to use the eraser or your paintbrush's transparency. You can't use black and white paintbrush like you do in Photoshop. It won't work. So once you've finished playing with your black and whites and erasing bits or adding bits, save as before, print your photos, do whatever you want with them, add them to Instagram, Facebook, whatever. Enjoy. And this isn't just the limitations, you can have fun with it whatever way. Like the black and white, you can do that with, say, sepia, or that looks red in my case because I chose the wrong color. But if you use a brown, it'll look more like sepia, like that. Or you can even do it blue. You can do whatever. Photo editing and art programs are just insane. I can make a green tiger. There you go. But I think I prefer him in black and white. It just contrasts with the eyes so much more nicer. If you have gotten this far, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed and found something useful. This is my first ever video tutorial, so I am sorry if it's a bit shaky or chaotic. If you did enjoy it, please leave a like and I'll know to keep making more. Alternatively, add in the comments if you would like any particular tutorial to be shown. Thank you for watching, have fun with it, and have a fantastic day. Thank you. See ya.